Now then, let's see, this will be our second match of day one. We're gonna have MRC versus GG, two tie turners, one on forward and the other one on psychologist, surprisingly. But game one, after the game we go, gonna see for Professor first. I mean, chasing after Professor first isn't too bad, but also at the same time, you need to consider the fact that one, like the scales is the main issue right now. No more, no less, it's really just the scales. Tries to get a hit on Professor right here. It seems like we're gonna knock the... Hey, the skill didn't land. Okay. Well, that's a bit sad, but seeing that we're gonna try vault over that right now. Professor has flywheel instead, but if we're able to give this to pallet stun though, which is the unfortunate issue right here. 45 seconds. Now, it seems like Xiaotong wants to get a normal hit here, which is understandable, but it seems like we're gonna get a little bit greedy breaking the pallet right there and getting a normal hit with the main follower. But we pulled a bit of a distance right there and flywheeled it all. Even if forward is here, I feel like forward cannot pull ball. Forward is pulling ball right now. Forward came back with the ball. Okay. I didn't understand that, but okay. We've three cypher machines almost done. Four cypher machine, which was at 50%. But now it simply means that Professor can go decode by himself right now, getting the leech on towards forward here once again. But the other issue is you don't have a patroller on your main body, so you need to put the patroller down with your main follower instead right here. What does this mean? This means that forward can contain for at least an extra 30 seconds for free. That's the issue here as well. Ku Cao is still having a full ball remaining on his hands. Even if we get bitten right here, or we most likely will be bitten here soon, but it seems like we decided to change back. The thing here is, right, Xiaozong canceled the patroller because he thought forward is going to go over and stun the main body. And when you stun the main body when patroller has been deployed, whatever follower has deployed the patroller, it basically gets canceled automatically. But here, as we do see as well, we're going to give a normal hit towards Fulan. There's two survivors currently at half health. PB Shock taking a normal hit there as well, but they're only missing 350% cypher machines. For Xiaozong right now, it's really hard on him trying to find any momentum here or any tempo here to get the survivors down. And even if you do get a forward down, it'll be only half a cypher remaining. Which is the very unfortunate part. Forward still having a third of a ball left, trying to pull the ball right here. Where is he rushing to? He's going to use the full ball rushing towards a nearby pallet, but this pallet is a little bit too short for him to play mind games against a patroller. But the good news is, it's game over. It's really game over. Just judging by the cypher machine progress right here, all you need to do is have an acrobat to come in to rescue. All you need to do is to have either an acrobat, no, you know what? Well, either an acrobat or a psychologist to come in to rescue. And then everything will be fine. You can have Psycho to rescue first for this 20 second tie turner to basically guarantee dash cypher machine prime. But it seems like we're going to open a new cypher at Birdcage right now from Fulan's side. So trying to play as much map control here as possible, but like once again the issue is you're trying to set up for a map control. Survivors realize that and survivors will immediately open an extra cypher. By the time that this forward has been shared, the cypher machine will be at least at 30% progress. And then like even if four can't sit on chair for long, even if four sits on chair like a normal survivor, does that matter much? No, not really, because like accelerated decoding is here and all. So survivors has done a really good job on like prolonging the game for as long as possible to get accelerated decoding out. So like for the end game right now, it's on survivor's side. End game's really on survivor's side. Dream Witch can't really map control here because of how far the cypher machines are away from each other. But we're gonna get the tie turning coming out from psychologist. Psycho wanting the bite block right here, the mini shell shot coming out. Forward taking the normal leech hit, which is fine. We'll have to leech on towards forward, but here we see once again 80% cypher machine, 20% tie turner time, 20 second tie turner time. It's gonna be more than enough. It's going to be more than enough for the cypher to be primed. It's popped. We're going to rush straight towards Fulan right now, still having patroller on Xiaotong's hands. But this is the second issue. You can put patroller down and you can grab your main body towards the gate. But realistically speaking, this is still going to just be a one-man elimination game. We're going to teleport out here immediately, getting the main body towards Fulan as fast as possible. Trying to play the window mind games right here, but getting bitched simply just means that There's nothing left for him to do, I guess. There really isn't. Yep, there we go. That's one man elimination. So let's congratulate GG for the 3-man escape. Moving on towards... Oh, are we going to go for... Are we going to be like last game, in which Wolves wanted to go for? But there's 76 seconds left on detention. Well, tie turner, so... Well, no, yeah, detention. So yeah, it seems like Kuzal decided to fully deleach himself. And it'll be a 3-man escape right here. Everyone's at shock, very relatively close towards the gate. Even if you leech on here, it seems like Xiaotong wanted to protect a little bit. Ah, that's unfortunate. That's unfortunate. Let's congratulate 3-man escape, moving on towards second half. Well, now then, second half we go. We're gonna have Saim coming out as Bonbon for this one. Anti-Crit immediately rotating into two-story, and then Xiao Di as well, deploying the coffin down. But we're both are running the same direction. But I guess for Nanako's main objective is to use flip as much as, well, not flip, to use spin as much as possible, just so she can tight kite and then run tight corners a little bit faster. But also jumping down right here, wanting to get Nanako did a really good job right there. Rotating out was the best decision. Why? It's because if Simon wants to play mind games right there, it'll take a little bit way too long for him to play any mind games. But with the that's a nice chip, Simon, very nicely done. But that's gonna be another swipe away from the bombs. That's gonna be a 5-second bomb on the ground. But it seems like Nanako will get a chip here immediately. No, he didn't, but that was a normal hit register though. He did have stab, but that was not the best place to use stab. But so it seems like our S badge anti-current decided not to use anything right there. Now then, with no insolence on hand, at least he can still play around a little bit, because this is a peepers bonbon, not a blink bonbon, of course, a peepers bonbon. So as long as Nanako just do his normal containment here, everything should be fine overall. But if we see right here, that's a very good flip over, and another pallet down as well, trying to play by as much time as possible. But it seems like we got a mini Terror Shock right there. Terror Shocking towards chip hunters hurts the most. It's to the chip hunters that hurts the most. No one else, just chip hunters. But with Nanako being nearby as well, utilizing... Is that a speed boost that I saw? I think I saw a mini speed boost. Decided not to use any spin right here. Why? It's simply just because of the fact that this is an annoying place to be in. But also, Nanako's location being revealed by peepers right now. We also see Xiao Di nearby wanting to give a little bit of an assist. But if we really want to do that, we'll be taking a chip here from Embalmer though. Embalmer also doesn't really have anything to use to contain. But for Nanako's side right now, we're playing so much back and forth. It's basically 2-in-1 situation here, in which Xiao Di cannot finish his cipher. Well, he wants to finish his cipher, but he can't. And of course, getting a chip right there, that's going to be a half-length Embalmer. At least Nanako didn't get any chip just yet. But with Saam's hands, he has 5 stacks of bombs on his hands. Trying to spin to get as far away from the location as possible, but it seems like Nanako is able to contain for a little bit longer. Perhaps he's able to get towards the pallet, but no pallet stone. No, the pallet stone will register just to buy a little bit more time. We're gonna rush straight towards the mercenary right now. We're gonna run straight towards the mercenary at statue. What does this mean? This means that they want the mercy to finish the last cipher machine in shock for what's right here. The problem with being here right now is Huatsu has to be very careful. Reason number one being the fact that he needs to finish that cipher machine, and reason number two is because of the fact that if he doesn't be careful and Nanako gets downed immediately, it'll be really bad for both sides. We're gonna get an immediate elbow pad in. No bombs, but we got a Terror Shock. Oh my god, no bombs, but we got a Terror Shock. No bombs, but we got a Terror Shock. Wait a second. No one can rescue now. No one can rescue. Wait a second. Was this supposed to work like this? It wasn't supposed to work like this, though. Oh no. This is going to be really hard now. This is actually going to be really hard now. We're going to abnormal that cipher machine. So it seems like we're going to have to open a completely new cipher right now. But at least Mercenary stays on the chair for a little bit longer than usual. Accelerated decoding is out. But look at Huatsu's health right now. One chip and he's dead. What can we do here? And for Sam, he's just not going out. Sam's main goal is, oh yeah, you know what? I'll just stay here. Screw you. It doesn't really matter. Why does it not matter? It's because... All he needs is a tie here. All he really needs is a tie. Going x-ray knows, well, he doesn't really know where the patient is, but probably can smell him out. Probably can smell him out a little bit, throwing a few bombs around just to check the locations. We're going to be able to see a few 5-second bombs. We are going to get a normal hit, but look at the bombs deployed down there. This is going to be really hard. Can we go in for the rescue, I wonder? But even if we can't go in for the rescue, Huata is just stuck there right now. Oh no. Oh no, oh no, oh no, oh no, oh no. That is such good bomb deployment. That is such good bomb deployment. It's a bare minimum 3-man elimination. I would even say it's close to a 4 right now if they can find Xiao Di. Oh no, 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 no. Oh no, 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 no. Ah, it's a terror shock. Ah, the terror shock changed everything. Ah, the terror shock. Wow. Wow, that sucks. That genuinely speaking sucks. But anyways, Xiao Di's gonna play around this pallet area for, well, no, this window for a while. But also at the same time, you need to consider a few things. The first thing being the fact that this is a bonbon in which you can basically just throw long bombs. And there's the tension, and we landed 2 bombs there. Wow. Wow. Remote control bomb should be able to take it home. Remote control bomb should be able to take you home right here. We're gonna jump down once again. Even if Xiao Di wants to loop here for long, it's not gonna last long though. Cause see, Huata is gonna stay on the chair for another like 20 seconds bare minimum. And then like the dungeon takes like 5 seconds to open because you're the last survivor remaining on the grounds. If survivor is left for the gate, the dungeon will open fast. But if you're the only, but if you're last one here, oof. Oof, unfortunate situations, isn't it? And there goes Xiao Di. Nice time bombs. Moving on.